najvažnijih poseta u našim bilateralnim odnosima. Naime, poslednji put kada smo imali visoku delegaciju u Beogradu, bila je 1989. godina, kada je Rajiv Gandhi posetio Beograd. Pre toga, od izuzetnog značaja, je bila poseta, rekao bih, i danas popularnog čoveka u Indiji, potpredsednika Indije, Rada Krišnana, i posle toga je 54. usledio čuveni susret Tito Nehru i, rekao bih, dalje zajednički i uspešan rad u pokretu nesvrstanih. Danas Srbija želi pre svega da čestite Indiji, predsedniku, vama potpredsedniče,
President, to you, Vice President, and to the Prime Minister Narendra Modi for the exceptional economic results. Those economic results are impressive. A country that always is among the two or three among the growth, regarding the growth rate, a country that is dramatically changing towards the better, the country that succeeded to change, I'd say, not only the point of view, not only Asia, but the entire world when it comes to them. And we are very happy because our Indian friends are successful in many things. What's really important in our cooperation on behalf of the Republic of Serbia, I want to thank you for clear decision of the Republic of India to support.
Mi prijatelje poštujemo, cenimo i, kao što rekoh, nikome se ne dodvoravamo, vodimo svoju nezavisnu politiku čuvanja slobode i suvereniteta naše srpske otadžbine. U skladu sa tim, Republika Indija može da računa na podršku Republike Srbije u brojnim međunarodnim telima, organizacijama, institucijama, uključujući Savet bezbednosti i Generalnu skupštinu Ujedinjenih nacija. Možete da računate na našu podršku i na naš glas, baš kao što smo mi uvek mogli da računamo na podršku Indije kada je u pitanju i očuvanje naše teritorijalne celovitosti i kada su u pitanju vitalni interesi Republike Srbije. Ono što je veoma važno bilo danas, a što ćemo nastaviti kroz razgovore na poslovnom forumu, jeste razvoj naših ekonomskih odnosa. Mi smo ove godine uspeli da uvećamo našu trgovinsku razmenu. Ona je prvi put došla do 200 miliona dolara. Ona mora da bude neuporedivo veća. I mi smo razgovarali o više različitih oblasti kako da to učinimo. Kao što znate, mi smo ukinuli vize za građane Indije, što znači da se nadamo da uspostavljanjem i vazdušnog saobraćaja, i vidjet ćemo kako i na koji način da pokušaju da se dogovore kroz različite koče aranžmane Air Srbija i Air India ili neka druga indijska kompanija, dakle da uspostavimo vazdušni most između Beograda i Delhija, Beograda i Mumbaja, da vidimo kako da povežemo naše narode, kako da uspostavimo što više kontakata između ljudi, između poslovnih ljudi. Široke oblasti saradnje imamo u poljoprivredi, u farmaciji. Danas smo pričali o generičkim lekovima, između ostalog. Mnogo toga očekujemo od indijskih investitora, posebno u oblasti digitalizacije, softvera, takođe u dodatnoj industrializaciji Republike Srbije, kao što sam siguran da će i naši investitori sa daljim svojim napretkom i sa još boljim uspesima u budućnosti biti sve zainteresovaniji za ulaganje u Indiju. Mi ćemo imati, ovo su prvi konkretni razgovori, prvi konkretni dogovori, te stvari ne idu brzo, ali će iz godine u godinu se videti pomaci u našoj saradnji. Indija danas ima 1,2 milijarde stanovnika, reč je o našem istinskom i iskrenom prijatelju, i verujem i uveren sam da ćemo u budućnosti, a u interesu obeju zemalja i naših naroda, dakle, uspjeti da obezbedimo još bolju saradnju. I siguran sam da ne samo ovih 70 godina diplomatskih odnosa, ne samo iskreno prijateljstvo koje nas je krasilo u prošlosti, već i budućnost, pre svega to što će da krasi naše odnose i što će da bude glavna odlika naše saradnje. Još jedan put, veliko hvala, poštovani potpredsjedniče Naidu, od vas sam danas mnogo toga mogao i da čujem, mnogo toga da naučim i o regionalnim i o globalnim pitanjima, i da dobro razumem, čini mi se, kako da našu malu zemlju još stabilnije postavimo u celom svetu. I hvala vam što ste Srbiju primetili na mapi sveta što vodite računa o Srbiji, a mi ćemo se postarati da ljudi Indije još više zavole Srbiju, jer ovde na svakom koraku i gde ste mogli da šetate jutros i gde ćete moći da šetate večeras, vidjet ćete poštovanje i rekao bih dobar odnos, odnos podrške i zajedništva od svakog našeg čovjeka. Još jedan put dobrodošli, radujem se nastavku našeg današnjeg rada i poslovnom forumu i zajedničkom ručku i radujem se našoj budućoj saradnji. Hvala vam najlepše.
Hvala predsjedniče. Obratit će nam se potpredsjednik Republike Indije, Venkaiah Naidu. Izvolite.
Your Excellency, President Aleksandar Vucic, Honorable Ministers of the Government of Serbia, Members of the Media, Brothers and Sisters, Namaskar. That means good afternoon. Namaskar is an Indian way of greeting others. It is my first visit to this beautiful country. The country is not only beautiful, but also people seems to be very dutiful. Because in short time, they could, under the able leadership, could develop this country as one of the important countries in this part of Europe. I am delighted to visit Serbia on the very first leg of my first trip to Europe in my current capacity. Earlier I was minister and political functionary, but now after assuming as the Vice President of India, this is my first trip to Europe, and that I am starting from Serbia. I thank the Honorable President Aleksandar Vucic and the people of Serbia for the warm welcome and hospitality extended to me and my fellow delegation members. We are happy to receive the President Vucic in India during his visit in January last year in his capacity as the Prime Minister of Serbia. India and Serbia have historic and special relations as co-founders of the NAM, that is Non-Aligned Movement. Our relationship is based on mutual trust, mutual understanding, and support to each other on issues of core interest. My visit to Serbia assumes special significance as both our countries are celebrating the 70th anniversary of establishment of diplomatic relations this year. That is very significant. I am happy that today Serbia Post and Indian Post have jointly released commemorative stamps on the renowned Serbian scientist and inventor Nikola Tesla and the great spiritual leader of India, Swami Vivekananda, to celebrate this occasion. I had extensive discussion with His Excellency President Vucic this morning on all important aspects of our bilateral relationship as well as global and regional issues of common interest to both of our countries. We expressed our commitment to further build on long-standing friendly ties between our countries. We agreed to expand the bilateral cooperation, especially in the areas of economic and cultural relations. In the area of economic cooperation, both sides have agreed to enhance cooperation in the areas of priorities such as agriculture, food processing, defense, manufacturing, science and technology, information technology, infrastructure, tourism, and pharmaceuticals. We expressed satisfaction at the investments made by Indian companies in Serbia, especially in sectors of farm equipments like tractors, food processing, and pharmaceuticals. India and Serbia are on the path of economic reforms to realize the goal of socio-economic development of our people. India is one of the fastest growing major economies in the world, presents opportunities for win-win partnership between Serbian and Indian partnership in multiple sectors to realize the vast potential of our bilateral relationship. Your Excellency, I welcome the signing of the two agreements during this visit. The agreement on cooperation, plant production and plant quarantine would contribute to increasing bilateral trade in agricultural products. The air service agreement would boost trade and tourism by launch of direct air connectivity between India to Serbia in future. We conveyed our mutual satisfaction at the growing cultural cooperation and people-to-people relations between both the countries. I thank the President Vucic for Serbia's unilateral decision to waive visa for short visits by Indians travelling to Serbia. India has also extended a visa, e-visa facility to Serbian nationals. Our initiatives would further promote tourism and greater people-to-people contact. In our discussions today, we also exchanged views on multilateral issues and agreed to intensify cooperation in the areas of mutual interest. India and Serbia have close cooperation at the United Nations and other multilateral fora. We agree that United Nations to be reformed to reflect the realities of today and address current global challenges. It is long overdue. We resolve to fight the scourge of terrorism in all its forms and manifestations and agree to strengthen cooperation in fight against terrorism at various international fora. It's a global challenge and requires a global response. Terror has no religion. Terrorism is the enemy of humanity. So we must all come together. I'm happy that both of us have agreed to move in the direction of creating the needed public opinion. I will also meet the Honorable Speaker of Serbian National Assembly, Her Excellency Mrs. Gojković, and Prime Minister, Her Excellency Mrs. Brnabić. I would have the honor to address the special session of the National Assembly of Serbia, President Vucic, and I will together attend the India-Serbia Business Forum and have opportunity to meet the business representatives of both the countries just after this event. I would once again thank the Honorable President Vucic for the warm welcome and gracious hospitality. I also extend warm greetings for the progress and prosperity of the people of Serbia. India looks forward for further closer cooperation with Serbia to further strengthen our traditional bonds of friendship with Serbia and its people. I have already assured the President that India stands for the sovereignty and territorial integrity of Serbia. There is no question of any dilution or deviation of our stand. I am also equally happy that the Honorable President has unequivocally publicly declared their support to India's cause in the United Nations and also in the other international forums. I am thankful to the Honorable President and his team and also to the people of Serbia for all the warmth and affection they are showing towards us during our stay. I hope that my two-day visit to this part of Europe will be a gateway for further cooperation and deeper understanding between India and European countries, starting with Serbia. Excellency, you have just said that Serbia is a small country. No, maybe size-wise small, but it's a tall and have a tall leader also. So I am sure in the coming days, Serbia will further grow in height and also join the process of development that is happening everywhere. The aspiration of the people, I'm sure, are being met, and then you will take further steps to bring reforms wherever they are needed. As our Indian Prime Minister is implementing the reforms, he has the three-line advice to everybody: reform, perform, and transform. Transforming the nation. I'm happy that both our Prime Minister and your good self, Excellency, are moving in the direction of transforming the respective nations. Together, we'll be able to transform the conditions of the humanity. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.
Thank you.
Samo ako mogu nešto. Dakle, if you, Your Excellency, if you allow me just to add a few sentences on this issue and will refer to my public audience just for two sentences. Pre svega, hoću da dodam još jednu stvar o kojoj smo razgovarali, to je saradnja u oblasti odbrane, veoma važna. Naše javno preduzeće Jugoimport SDPR već 3 godine za redom vodi važne razgovore u Indiji, određeni predugovori su potpisani, nastavit ćemo sa tom saradnjom i verujemo da ćemo postići i dostići veoma visoke ciljeve koje smo postavili u našoj vojno-tehničkoj saradnji. Verujemo da ima još mnogo prostora za saradnju u vojno-obrazovnom, vojno-zdravstvenom delu. To je još jedna od oblasti u kojima mislimo da možemo da postignemo veliki napredak i koja bi značajno uticala na povećanje naše kako trgovinske, tako i tehnološke razmene. Zamolio bih za još 2 minuta pažnje, imam za kraj jednu dobru vest, a pre toga imam nešto što mi je pomalo neprijatno, pošto moram da se izvinim građanima Srbije za glupost koju sam sinoć izgovorio ili grešku koju sam napravio. Mnogi su jedva dočekali, pošto nisu mogli da kažu bilo šta o suštini onoga o čemu sam pričao. Ja sam sinoć na jednoj konferenciji za novinare, govoreći o nesrećama u građevinskom sektoru koje se dešavaju u svetu, rekao kako na svakih 10 sekundi ginu perači prozora u Americi, sa nekog šaljivog sajta uzeto, i nisu krivi moji savjetnici što su mnogi dočekali da ih optuže. Kriv sam ja da sam malo razmislio, da nisam bio umoran, shvatio bih odmah, ali kako bih rekao, normalno je da grešite, a ja ću ovu priliku da iskoristim da pohvalim moje savjetnike i moj tim, jer je to najbolji tim, tim koji donosi samo pobede i koji je uvek do sada pobeđivo i pobeđivaći i u buduće. A što se tiče dobre vesti, tako da to što je bila glupost i to što sam ja ispao glup, šta da radim? Bez loše namere, bez zle namere, čak i ne vidim da je bilo kakav suštinski zaključak to moglo da promeni. Što se tiče dobre vesti, pozvao sam, zamolio sam Zlatibora Lončara, zamolio sam gospođu Brnabić i rekao sam da smo spremni da se odreknemo određenih stvari iz tekuće budžetske rezerve i na nivou lokalnih samouprava koje to očekuju, da bismo pomogli malom Dušanu Todoroviću 4-godišnjem i država će preuzeti sve obaveze na sebe. Mislim da je ovo vest koja je obradovala celu Srbiju. Mnogo smo ulagali u zdravstvo, mnogo smo novca dali, mnogo više dece uspevamo da izlečimo danas nego ranije, ali je Dušan prirastao svima za srce. Trudimo se da svakome pomognemo i ja sam zamolio da tu nema granica, već da urade sve što mogu da se malom Dušanu pomogne. To je, ukoliko još nešto možemo na taj način, to ćemo da uradimo. Hvala još jedan put i izvinite što sam ovo vreme zloupotrebio.
Hvala predsjedniče, hvala vam, ovim je današnje obraćanje završeno.
Thank you very much. Nice of you. Thanks a lot.